science also offers clues as to what might be going on in a psychopath's brain. At the University of Wisconsin, Dr. Mike Koenigs uses an MRI scanner to compare the brains of normal subjects with those of psychopaths in prison.
So there's a specific circuit very deep in the brain that is responsive to essentially anything that we find innately pleasurable. So things like money, drugs, sex, chocolate. When you look at a psychopathic brain's response to reward, what we find is that the more psychopathic the individual is, the stronger that this area of the brain lights up to reward, called the amygdala, primary sort of fear center of the brain. And another circuit of the brain that we know to be responsible for empathy, for the regulation of emotion, for motivating pro-social behavior, for regulating our moral judgments, we also see some degraded connections in that circuit of the brain.
There is reduced connectivity between these two areas of the brain, the amygdala and the prefrontal cortex. The primitive emotions of fear and pleasure-seeking weren't being moderated by the brain's executive power center.
You have brains that seem to be hypersensitive to reward, brains that seem to be undersensitive to the suffering of others. This is the picture of psychopathy, right? So this is a brain of someone who is very dangerous,